Bonjour à toute la classe.
Bonjour.
Your chef.
How y'all doing this morning?
Good morning.
Morning.
Good morning.
Bonjour, chef.
Good morning. Bonjour.
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 This is Cooking and Learning Care segment with Chef Destiny and... We can't hear you, Aja. So we got Shawanda and Brenton is off for today. So.
Okay.
Aja, we still can't hear you, boo.
Hear me now?
Okay,
can
yes.
You hear me?
Thank you. It's going in and out.
Oh, I'm so sorry. It might be the weather. I don't know.
Okay, I'm replacing the spotlight. So you can go ahead and get started.
All right. Everybody.
Good morning.
Everybody doing okay?
Yes.
Good morning. I hope y'all can hear me. All right. I'm going to be cooking a recipe, two recipes today. I don't know.
Aja, can you type in the chat box what you're making? It's just going in and out. It's the weather.
I'm sorry. I'm gonna
it's
type
okay.
It. Okay. So I have the salmon. I squeeze some lemon juice on it. Just a little slight squeeze of lemon juice on it. I have a seasoning blend. You can make whatever seasoning blend you want. I just put salt, pepper, oregano, dried thyme, garlic powder, onion powder. But feel free to do whatever you want. All right. Season that. I mean, make sure you get all the pieces of salmon covered. Now, sometimes when you fry salmon, people say it can be dry. So I'm going to put a little bit of mayonnaise on it to coat it to kind of help with not having it get dry when it fries. But I'm also not going to fry it very long because you see the size, it doesn't need very long to fry. Okay.
Can you get the what you're cooking? Because we couldn't hear it.
Oh, I'm sorry. Fried salmon bite lettuce cup.
Okay.
So I'm going to be frying bite-sized pieces of lettuce. Of salmon. And putting into lettuce cup.
Okay. Okay.
So I have my seasoned salmon bite with a little mayonnaise so the flour can stick to it. And I'm just going to toss it into my flour. Now you can use cornmeal, you can use cornstarch, whatever you want. You can use panko crumbs if you like. I have flour, so I'm using flour. I have my heated oil. All right. Just to drop the salmon bite into the oil. Let it get a little bit hot. And I really can put all of this in here, but I'm just going to do like this. Right? Just let that fry. My oil could have been a little bit hotter, but it's going to be okay. Wash my hands. All right. So as you know, whenever you're frying something, you want to make sure that you have what you're going to take out immediately. Make sure you have it ready in reserve. Thank you. Like I said, this takes about maybe 3 or 4 minutes. It really doesn't take long. Right? Let that go a little bit longer. Now, as that is frying, we're going to make our veggies that go inside of the lettuce cup. So I just have some bib lettuce that I'm going to use for my lettuce cup, okay? I also have some red onion, some red bell pepper, some cucumber that I kind of slice relatively thin, kind of like a slaw. You can use any veggies you want, okay? But I also have some fresh dill. And dill and salmon pair really well together. They have a lot of salmon and dill dishes. So we're gonna just put some of the fresh dill into our little slaw that we have. And we're gonna hit that with some lemon juice too. Now, if you wanna salt and pepper that, that's fine. But it's gonna really, you know, it's gonna be just a fresh. So you just mix that together. And the longer it sits, you know, the juices from the veggies is gonna come out and it's gonna all get to know each other. But it's still gonna taste good if you have to eat it immediately. All right, at this point, our salmon should be done. So we just take the salmon out. It's a nice golden brown. And as soon as we take the salmon out, we're gonna hit the fried salmon with some fresh squeeze of lemon juice too. Okay. All right. Turn our oil. We'll just put it aside. Now we can assemble our lettuce cup. So you just take your bib lettuce. I'm going to start off with two. And you just put your salmon bite into your lettuce cup.
Looks good.
Yes. Cucumber, red pepper, red onion slaw, and that fresh dill. All right. And for like a little dressing, you can do your favorite salad dressing because once again, this is your. But I just put a little hot sauce, you know, like some tea, and a little ranch, and I just drizzle that on top. And this is just a little healthy way. You can call it a shrimp taco. A salmon taco or just a little lettuce cup. It's very delicious. Just a little cute way.
It looked delicious.
Yes.
Yes, that looks good.
Now, a quick second recipe. It's very simple, but very delicious. You just get you a banana and you're going to poke some holes in it. Now we have an oven that is preheated at 300 degrees. We're gonna put the whole banana into the oven. When this banana, it's going to be it's a very delicious sweetener. When the sugars come out of the banana, it still tastes like a banana, of course, but it has a completely different flavor profile. So we put this in the oven. So this is how it looks when it comes out. Not very appetizing. Very delicious on the inside. So you just get to a bowl. We'll get a knife. Your banana open. Now I have a sea salt caramel syrup that I use. I really like it. It's in the skin. But you can take it out. So I just hit it with a little bit of this sea salt Ghirardelli caramel syrup.
That's some good syrup.
It's salty and sweet at the same time. And I'm going to be a little healthy and hit it with some yogurt. But you can use it. You know, and then also if you want a crunch factor, you can have some crushed up some granola bars or something on top. And this is just a nice little cute, healthful dessert. I like the warm fruit with the cold yogurt or the cold ice cream. I like that combination. But hopefully, you know, y'all like this. Are there any questions about these two recipes?
I see what you did, Black History, Black Banana.
It could have been.
I love it.
So, Aja, how long did you keep the banana in the oven?
About 20 minutes.
Okay. And then you said you could put like yogurt on the side, or I mean, can you make it like a little smushed banana split? You know, put it, put your stuff in the banana.
That'd be cute. With your cherry and stuff on top. That would be very cute. Yeah.
Yeah. Okay.
Okay.
Good deal. I love both of those recipes. Beautiful. Thank you.
Aja, I don't have a question, but in yesterday's paper, there's another black chef and another black restaurant opening. His name is Sim Walker. Sim Walker. And he has a restaurant called It's Isis, which is in Decatur, and he's opening up apartment 4B in Buckhead, and it's a Caribbean restaurant with authentic Caribbean food.
Okay. You know, and that's him. Oh, I can't.
Maybe we can start a supper club once we get back and things open up.
Yep. Hey, gonna have music and everything.
Wow.
Oh, that's what he looks like.
Is that him?
Pull it up, Juliet. Yeah.
Okay.
And what's the name of the restaurant again?
Called Apartment 4B.
Oh, that's the restaurant. That's
the one that's already opening. Open is Miss Isis, I-C-E-Y apostrophe S kitchen, and it's in Decatur.
Gotta check that out.
Oh, yeah.
Isis kitchen.
What type of food they serve,
Bethany? What? The food in Decatur is soul food. But the food is he's opening up now. It's gonna be authentic Caribbean food.
Auntie, you got that wrote down?
Yes.
Okay.
All right.
I got our name written down. I just need her address so I can spend the night one night. So I can be rich.
All right, y'all. Y'all ready for hot tips and hack? Oh, there goes Shawanda. Thank you. Finally, some good light, that beautiful face. Come on with it.
Good morning, everybody.
Good morning.
Hope everybody's staying nice and dry. These are my tips and hacks. Number one, to soften hardened brown sugar, place an apple slice in a container, seal, let it sit overnight. Two, toss your dry fruit and berries with flour before adding them to your batter. This stops them from sinking. Three, avoid using cold eggs in your batter. Instead, place eggs in warm water for 10 to 15 minutes. And four, if you want to reduce spreading, you can chill the dough before shaping and slightly reducing the oven temperature. And five, my food hack is stick an ice cream cone on top of the cupcake batter and bake. The cake ends up rising into the cone. You can put ice cream or icing on top for an original birthday dessert.
I like that.
Thank you so much.
Thank you. That's good. I bet the flour too.
I'm looking at this food from that restaurant. It looks so good. All right, I just want to let y'all know, yesterday, them soul rolls, they was out of sight. I know some of y'all don't like all that mixing up, but they were very delicious. So first thing I want to do today, this is our last class for February. And let me see, somebody put something in the chat. Ms. Cheryl put the website to Apartment 4B restaurant in the chat box. So if y'all want to get that. All right. So first thing I want to do with you guys is we're going to do a, since this is the last day of February, doesn't mean Black History goes anywhere because we are Black History every day.
Every day.
But I want to do a breathing exercise with y'all, if that's all right. It's called the 4-7-8 breathing exercise. And this is a calming exercise. Can everybody see the screen?
Yeah.
Okay. Now, V tells you to close your eyes, but if you don't want to close your eyes, you don't have to. Just listen to the instructions, and we're going to get some nice, calm breathing motions together to enjoy the rest of your day. So here we go.
Breathing exercise that will allow your body to become calmer. And to make yourself comfortable as you gently close your eyes. Inhale through your nose for a count of 4. Hold the breath for a count of 7. And exhale through your mouth for a count of 8. Don't worry if you aren't exact here. Just do your best. Inhale, 1.
Here we go.
2, 3, 4. Hold. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And exhale. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Good. Inhale. 1, 2, 3, 4. Hold. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And exhale. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. You're doing a good job. Inhale. 1, 2, 3, 4. Hold. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And exhale. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Keep going. Inhale. 4. Hold for 7. And exhale. 8. Let it all go. Feel the stress release and your shoulders soften. Okay. Inhale. 4. Hold for 7. And exhale. 8. One more time.
One more time, yeah.
4. Hold for 7. And exhale. 8. You can take a few more deep breaths or allow your breathing to return to its natural rhythm as you breathe through your nose. Hopefully, you feel a little more relaxed at this point. When you're ready, gently open your eyes and sit quietly for a moment before you get up.
All right. Everybody feel a little better?
Yes. I do.
I do these type of exercises during the week. You need something to relax you. I do them at night. I listen to the positivity through the night. So it's conditioning and trains my brain to think different and to think positive. And on the lines with that, I want to give you 10 foods to help build muscles for seniors and for anyone, but we'll go through them. First one is meat. Okay, sorry, y'all. So the first one is meat. Animal meats are rich in protein and valuable in senior health, supplying approximately 7 grams of protein per 1 ounce. I'm not gonna read everything, just gonna go through some. Next one is fatty fish. It's also supply considerable protein while being appropriate consistencies for seniors to chew. Then we have tofu. Tofu may be a significant protein alternative for individuals eliminating or reducing meat intake. I haven't become a fan of it yet, but we shall see. The next one is eggs. Dismiss the worry of the dietary cholesterol found in eggs, as new recommendations actually encourage their intake in moderate amounts. And it gives you healthy fats and fat-soluble vitamins. The next one is milk. It supplies adequate protein and calcium to encourage both muscle and bone strength. Also, cheese. Sprinkle atop salads, layer a slice on the sandwich, drizzle cheese sauce on potatoes or other veggies. Cottage cheese is also encouraged food to build muscle, supplying 12 grams of protein per half cup. The next one is beans. They are both protein and fiber packed, making them not only a food to build muscle, but good for digestive health as well. Next, we have nuts. Almonds, pecans, walnuts, and several other nuts are significant sources of both healthy fats and protein. Peanut butter is an appreciated substitution for crunchy nuts, particularly if seniors have difficulties chewing and swallowing them. You can add peanut butter into smoothies and oats, dip with cracker sticks, smear on apple slices or banana. Or sometimes just get a spoonful of peanut butter.
That's what we did.
And the last one is protein powders. Although dietitians and nutritionists encourage eating whole foods over supplemental products, protein powders may be a valuable alternative for seniors with a reduced appetite. But make sure you discuss it with your dietitian and your primary caregiver. Okay. And the theme of my class today is stand. And that's why I'm talking about muscle building, why we did a breathing exercise. Because sometimes, especially being at home all the time, you don't get to move around a lot. So right now, I just want everybody to get up, and we ain't going to do no exercising or nothing, because y'all should have did that with Miss Buffy. You just going to get up and release some stuff off you, move around, get that blood flowing. Just so you're not always sitting and standing. If you find yourself sitting and standing, just get up and move around. Get that blood flowing. And y'all can cut your favorite music on, dance you a little jig. I have my own concerts in my room all the time by myself. That's right, baby. Get up, move it around.
Right.
All right. Thank y'all. So the next thing we're going to go over is 25 simple ways to balance your mind, body, and soul. Now, I can tell y'all from my experience previously, before I, you know, start changing some things in my life. That stress will jack you up inside and out. So you have to change your pattern of thinking and everything that you do. So we're gonna go through a couple of these. Read and learn often. Meditate regularly. There's nothing wrong with being by yourself sometimes. Because sometimes you need to clear your head and unfog it and clear your thoughts and just be by yourself. Practice yoga. My sister is a yoga instructor. The first time I did yoga with her, I thought I was going to die. I was sweating. I was like, I didn't know yoga did all that. But I felt so relaxed and stretched out afterwards. And since I've been doing my healthy journey, because my sister used to tell me, you know, you just get this surge of energy and feeling that lets you know you need to exercise and that you want to exercise. I was like, I don't know if I'm ever going to be like that wanting to exercise. But now that I do on the regular, I do. I don't know if it's a mind thing or what, but I have to get that surge of energy in the day, whether it's 15 minutes, 30 minutes, an hour, or whatever. Mm-hmm. Avoid sitting for extended periods of time, just what we were talking about. Especially if you have difficulty in any kind of blood circulation problem, you want to keep that body moving, keep that body flowing, that blood flowing. Get at least 15 minutes of moderate to fast-paced exercise in each day. Spend time outside. Sometimes go outside. Everybody been in the house breathing and everything. Get outside and get you some of that fresh air or crack a window. Add more plant-based foods to your diet. Get involved in volunteer organization or activism group. Fuel your passion. Set aside time each day to make a list or something or do something that you really like to do. Listen to music. Music always helps me. Whether I'm busting out in a cry or dancing or whatever, music actually does calm the savage beat. Be grateful. When you wake up in the morning, instead of grabbing that cell phone or that laptop, thank whoever you give your praise to every day for waking up and having that breath of fresh air, because we don't know what could happen during the night. Be kind to everyone, and this includes yourself. Be kind to yourself first so you know how to give it to other people and that you can receive it. Now, all the time, situations come, you're not going to be nice. Like with me, I have really bad road rage. But when I get to going off now or cussing folk out in the car, you know what, Lord, they might be going through something. I'm sorry. God bless you. So I just start telling them, God bless you. But you have to keep on checking yourself. Get enough sleep each night. Sleep is very important. It is also called the fasting stage, because your body is not eating anything. You're actually fasting through the night. Your body is replenishing itself, healing anything that was wrong throughout the day. So please get enough sleep. Detoxify your beauty routine. Switch to natural products. Y'all know I like looking cute. I like makeup, but I really only do my eyes. I can't do like foundation and all of that. My skin is very sensitive. I haven't found a product that I'm ready to use yet as far as on my skin. Plus, I like my natural skin, blemishes and all. But you can get some turmeric and stuff like that and work on dark patches and stuff of that nature. Get harsh chemical cleaners out of your house. Shop green cleaners or make your own. Find a career path that is meaningful to you if you're still in a career phase. Let go of the little things, stuff that you can't help, like internet. I know I was frazzled earlier this week, but thank gosh I got a great boss, because she called me like, is you all right? Because you was just frazzled. I know you weren't yourself, and I kind of had to let it get to me a little bit, but thankfully, I got the skills to know how to turn it around. Stop people pleasing. We can't please everybody. I know that for sure, because I work for y'all, for seniors. And I cannot please every last one of y'all all the time, even with the food. Somebody gonna have something to say, but you know you're doing your best, then don't worry about the rest. That's what I say. Okay. Cut major sources of stress out your life, and that is including people, unhealthy relationships, a job you hate, clutter, anything like that that is causing you stress. Avoid the gossip and the drama. I know sometimes it's hard to do it because we just like to age. But sometimes you got to avoid any that's negative, at least. Laugh often. I know sometimes you might not even go through a whole day of laughing, but sometimes I watch stuff just so I can laugh. And I mean, I get a good old gut-busting laugh. I don't care if everybody in the house hear me laugh sometimes, because you need a good laugh sometimes, because we see so much negativity every day when you cut the TV on. Travel and learn about other countries. I won't recommend this right now, but if you are going to do it, make sure you be safe. Get you one of Miss Betty's crochet masks and you will be perfectly safe, because ain't nothing getting through the mask. Thank you, Miss Betty. Opt for natural remedies whenever you can. And that's the last one. I hope some of those tips helped y'all out or you learned something. I so appreciate y'all being in class and being faithful students every day. Even when y'all can't be, y'all call me and tell me, Chef, I ain't gonna be able to make it. I'm gonna be at the doctor or so-and-so. I really appreciate that. That lets me know that I'm making a difference. I was just making a difference. Brenton and Shawanda making a difference. So Black History, instead of just reading y'all what the Black History facts was for today, I wanted to share with y'all 15 untold Black History inventors that wasn't taught at school. So here we go.
Most people have heard about famous inventions like the light bulb, the cotton gin, and the penicillin. But did you know that many of the products we use every day were created by Black people?
Can you turn it up, Destiny?
15 of them that, until now, you probably didn't know.
That's the loudest my computer go.
McKinley Jones, if your refrigerator has any produce from your local grocery store, African American inventor Frederick McKinley Jones. Jones took out more than 60 patents throughout his life, including a patent for the roof-mounted cooling system that's used to refrigerate goods on trucks during extended transportation in the mid-1930s. He received a patent for his invention in 1940 and co-founded the U.S. Thermo Control Company, later known as Thermo King. The company was critical during World War II, helping to preserve blood, food, and Dr. Shirley Jackson. Dr. Shirley Jackson is an American physicist who received her PhD from the Massachusetts Institute of Technology in 1973. She was the first African-American woman to earn a doctorate in nuclear physics at MIT. In addition to her lengthy list of academic achievements, she also has an impressive number of inventions under her belt. Her experiments with theoretical physics paved the way for numerous developments in the telecommunication space, including the touch-tone telephone, the portable fax, caller ID, call waiting, and the fiber optic cable. Today, Dr. Shirley Jackson is the 18th president of Rensselaer Polytechnic Institute in Troy, New York. Louis Latimer. Inventor and engineer Louis Latimer was born in Chelsea, Massachusetts, on September 4, 1848. He collaborated with science greats Hiram Maxim and Thomas Edison. One of Latimer's greatest inventions was the carbon filament, a vital component of the light bulb. His inventions didn't stop there. Working with Alexander Graham Bell, Latimer helped draft the patent for Bell's design of the telephone. This genius also designed an improved railroad car bathroom and an early air conditioning unit. So the next time you're escaping a hot day inside your cool house, don't forget to thank Louis Latimer. Marie Van Britten Brown. Did you know that the first home security system was invented by a Black nurse? Meet Marie Van Britten Brown. Although she was a full-time nurse, she recognized the security threats to her home and devised a system that would alert her of strangers at her door and contact relevant authorities as quickly as possible. Her original invention consisted of peepholes, a camera, monitors, and a two-way microphone. The finishing touch was an alarm button that, when pressed, would immediately contact the police. Her patent laid the groundwork for the modern closed-circuit television system that is widely used for surveillance, home security systems, push-button alarm triggers, crime prevention, and traffic monitoring. Otis Boykin. Otis Boykin's most notable contribution to science was likely the circuit improvements he made to pacemakers after losing his mother to heart failure, a contribution that has saved countless lives since. But this single improvement was among a long list of achievements. Boykin had 26 patents in his name and is famed for the development of IBM computers, burglar-proof cash register, chemical air filters, and an electronic resistor used in controlled missiles and other devices. Lonnie G. Johnson. Did you ever enjoy water gun fights as a kid? Well, meet Lonnie Johnson, the man that gave us the most famous water gun, the Super. Lonnie wasn't a toy maker. He was actually an aerospace engineer for NASA with a resume boasting a stint with the US Air Force, work on the Galileo Jupiter probe and Mars Observer project, and more than 40 patents. Yes, he is also working on the Johnson Thermoelectric Energy Converter, JTEC, which converts heat directly into electricity, but it's the squirt gun he created that has given us all the most joy. Charles Drew. Every 2 seconds someone in the US needs blood. Thanks to Charles Drew, that blood is available. Drew was a physician, surgeon, and medical researcher who worked with a team at Red Cross on groundbreaking discoveries around blood transfusions. In World War II, he played a major role in developing the first large-scale blood banks and blood plasma programs. He also invented the, and get ready because this name is pretty charming, Bloodmobiles. These are the refrigerated trucks that, to this day, safely transport stored blood to the location where it is needed most. Drew was one of the most prominent doctors working in his field, and one of the only African Americans, during a time when blood donation was still separated along lines of race. Drew eventually resigned from his position with the American Red Cross over their insistence on adhering to this policy. It was 1950 before the Red Cross finally recognized all blood as being equal. Marion R. Croke. In 2013, Marion Croke was inducted into Women in Technology International's Hall of Fame, a move that recognizes her remarkable achievements in tech. Croke holds over 135 patents, primarily in voice-over internet protocol, VoIP, some in other areas. She has another 100 patents currently under review. Today, Marion is an SVP at AT&T, serves as a mentor for women in AT&T Labs, and sits on the board for the Holocaust, Genocide and Human Rights Education Center. Lisa Jalopter. If you ever enjoyed an animated GIF on the web, like this one amazing clip of a kitten being scared by an iguana, then you have Lisa Jalopter to thank. Jalopter was integrally involved with the advent of Shockwave, a technology that formed the beginning of web animation. She also played a major role in the emergence of online video, later serving on the senior management team at Hulu. Previously, Lisa was the interim head of digital for Bet Networks and ran technology, product and business operations. Today, you can catch Lisa at the White House, in the United States Digital Service. She is currently serving as the Chief Digital Service Officer with the U.S. Department of Education. Philip Imigwali. Due to cost, Philip Imigwali was forced to drop out of school at age 14. But this didn't stop him from becoming one of the greatest computer pioneers of our time. In fact, he's often called the Bill Gates of Africa. As an adult, Imigwali began studying nature, specifically bees. The construction of the honeycomb inspired him to rethink computer processing. In 1989, he put this idea to work, using 65,000 processes to invent the world's first supercomputer, able to perform 3.1 billion calculations per second. Jesse Ernest Wilkins Jr. Jesse Ernest Wilkins Jr. is one of America's most important contemporary mathematicians. At 13, he became the University of Chicago's youngest student. Wilkins continued his studies there, earning bachelor, master, and eventually earning his doctorate degree in mathematics at the age of 19. He's published papers in mathematics, optics, and nuclear engineering. As a mathematician for the American Optical Company in Buffalo, New York, he perfected lens design for microscopes and ophthalmologic uses. His greatest contribution to scholarship was the development of mathematical models to explain gamma radiation and his work on developing a shielding against gamma radiation. His other claim to fame came from working on the Manhattan Project. At the Manhattan Project, Wilkins worked with future Nobel laureate Eugene Wigner and made significant contributions to nuclear reactor physics, now known as the Wilkins effect and the Wigner-Wilkins spectrum. Elijah McCoy. Often regarded as one of the most famous black inventors ever, McCoy was credited for 50 inventions over the span of his career. In an effort to improve efficiency and eliminate the frequent stopping necessary for lubrication of trains, McCoy devised a method of automating the task. In 1872, he developed a lubricating cup that could automatically drip oil when and where needed, vital in avoiding sticking to the track. The lubricating cup met with enormous success, and orders for it came in from railroad companies all over the country. It was so popular that when other inventors attempted to steal his idea and sell their own versions of the device, companies were not fooled. They insisted on the authentic device, calling it the real McCoy.
The real McCoy.
Those who survived either of the world wars thanks to a gas mask have Garrett Morgan to thank. Morgan first created the safety hood to help firefighters navigate smoky buildings, later modifying it to carry its own air supply, making it the world's first effective gas masks. He also had the good sense to add a third position to the traffic signal. Yes, there was a time when traffic signals just said indicated, stop, or go, an addition that further reduced automobile accidents. Mary and Mildred Davidson. Mary and her sister Mildred patented many practical inventions. They didn't have technical education, but they were both exceptional at spotting ways to make people's lives better. Together, they invented the sanitary belt. Later, Mary invented the moisture-resistant pocket for the belt. While disabled from multiple sclerosis, Mary went on to invent the walker and the toilet tissue holder.
All right, we salute y'all.
Okay.
Oh, I didn't even know all of that. That was awesome.
Yes.
Now, this is our last class for February, and I wanted to leave it on a great note. I'm going to play one of my favorite songs. If everybody knows Cynthia Erivo, what I was saying, the theme of my class today was Stand. If y'all know, she has a song called Stand. So I'm going to play that. If you need to get off or go to another class, you're more than welcome. But this is going to be our going out for the class today. Before I play it, let's go through the national holidays for today. National Pistachio Day, National Tell a Fairy Tale Day, and Skip the Straw Day.
Okay, Destiny, you are having classes next week, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Okay.
I'm just saying, next week we're going to be into March.
Okay.
That's all. So, this is our closing out. Hold on. I'll make sure I did the share screen. What's on? And if y'all wanted to go watch that on your own, that was Cynthia Erivo from the Harriet Tubman movie. Every time I hear it, it just makes me cry. She did such a good job. She's such a phenomenal actress. And that's such a strong and powerful song and a message for everybody. So you want to go listen to it, it's Cynthia Erivo, Stand Up. But that's the end of our class today, our last day of February. Salute to all the Black people who've made a difference in this world, and to all of us for making a difference every day. We're here for a reason. That's why we are here. And we're going to give ourselves our last hug for February. And fall in love with the process of becoming the best version of yourself. Well, I love y'all. Have a beautiful, blessed day.
Love you too.
We'll see y'all next month for March Madness. Y'all be blessed out there. Bye, y'all.
Bye.
Take care.
Take care.